Hello again and welcome back to our course on Word 2013. In this section we're going to look at what's new in Word 2013. I've already mentioned that the use of touch devices is a feature throughout Office 2013 now, and of course Word is no exception to that. So one of the things that I'll be coming back to from time to time is how to do things in Word 2013 using a touch device. But in this section I want to look specifically at some of the new features and functionality of Word 2013. Now there's a very useful page on the Microsoft.com website in the Office section called What's New in Word 2013, and that lists, with a little bit of explanation in each case, the main functional changes in Word 2013. So let's go through the main ones now and then we'll come back to each of them in detail later on in the course. Let's start with New Read Mode, and this is a new mode that's available in Word whereby virtually all of the, if you like, the clutter, the commands and so on are removed from the screen and make it behave much more like a sort of a book reader. Now many of you can probably guess where the idea of this has come from and why Microsoft are promoting this approach to using Word. But as you'll see later on, it's actually a really good feature, because apart from the fact that you can just sit and read a document with it, you can also have certain tools still handy, such as things like searching on the web, translating, and so on. That's a very useful new mode in Word. Now, if you've used Word before, you'll be very familiar with zooming in and out to either look at something more closely or to get a broader zoomed out view of a page or a couple of pages or whatever. Object Zoom is a new feature which gives you a very quick way of getting close up to something. So perhaps you want to look closely at a picture or the contents of a table where perhaps the text is quite small. Object Zoom lets you zoom straight in close up to something, and then when you finish looking at it close up, you can just tap outside the object and zoom back out to where you were before. So another useful new feature within Word 2013. Now of course much of the emphasis with Word 2013 is on catering for online storage of documents, saving them in the cloud, specifically on Microsoft SkyDrive. And one of the situations people are in, particularly when they store documents in the cloud, is if you're working on a remote version of a document, it's stored online, and you may well be using different devices in different locations at different times of the day yourself. So let's suppose you have a PC at work, you may use a laptop when you're visiting customers, you may use a different device when you're at home. When you come to access an online document, a new feature called Resume Reading in Word 2013 enables you to carry on with the document exactly where you left off. And that's a great feature, particularly if you're dealing with a long document and maybe you just want to make sure that you haven't got to spend several minutes finding where you are before you can carry on reading and perhaps reviewing a document. Another useful feature, when you have an adequate internet connection of course, is the ability to watch an online video right from within a Word document. So the Word document contains the necessary link to take you through to the video, and when you're at that point in the document you can literally just play the video, as I said, provided you have an adequate internet connection at that time. And a very useful feature, particularly when you're working with long documents, is the ability to collapse or expand parts of a document with just a tap on the screen or a click of the mouse. This means you can put a summary of a section in a heading and then let each reader decide whether they want to open the section and read the details. Many of the new and improved features in Word 2013 relate to working together with other people on documents. And this extends to not only saving files in the cloud, but also being able to share files in the cloud. And now there are good facilities for actually working on the same document as colleagues at the same time as those colleagues. So you can both work on the same file at the same time. Now there are some constraints and restrictions on this, but subject to those, it's a pretty effective way of working collaboratively on a document. Not only can you share documents on SkyDrive, of course, but there are extensive facilities generally for sharing documents using Microsoft SharePoint. Another feature that's important for collaborative working, and if you've ever done collaborative working, I'm sure you'll be familiar with it, is change tracking in Word. Now, in Word 2013, there is a new revision view called Simple Markup, which provides a clean, uncomplicated view of the document, but where you can still see where tracked changes have been made. One of the very long-standing features in Word related to collaborative working is the use of comments. Well, in Word 2013, you can reply to comments and you can mark the comments as done. Although if you do, although the comments are grayed out, they're still there, so you can still see the history of a conversation about a comment. Nowadays, the standards of presentation in documents are very high, generally speaking. And more, Word, which started out as a pretty straightforward word processing package, is now seen as something close to a desktop publishing package. And in Word 2013, there are a whole new range of templates available, and these templates have been updated for a modern, crisp, clean look and feel. Now, for a very long time, Adobe PDF format, portable document format, has been the standard for interchanging readable documents. And for a few versions of Word, it's been possible to generate, to write PDF format documents as versions of Word documents that you've been working on. Well, in Word 2013, you can actually now open PDFs and you can edit the content. Now, many of the features you use in Word are available. There are constraints and restrictions that we'll go over later in the course, but basically this is the first time that you've been able to open and edit PDFs. And finally, another very useful feature in terms of the presentation of a document is the new Live Layout and Alignment Guide facility, where as you move photos and shapes around in your document, you get a live preview of how the document will look in each of the possible sizes and orientations and so on. So there we have it, that's a whistle-stop tour of the new features in Word 2013, and it's now time to get started on the course proper. The first thing I'm going to look at is the use of touch in Word 2013. If you've used any components of Office 2013 already, many of the features of touch in Word follow the general pattern from within Office 2013, and there is information about that available on the Microsoft.com website. But for the purposes of this course, I'm going to go over the basics of use of touch in Office 2013 generally first, and then I'll cover the specific aspects of using touch in specific aspects of Word 2013 as we go through the course. So, that's it for now. I'll see you in the next section.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Office 2013 training to the next level, you can get over 70 hours of Microsoft Office 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.